Jay mentioned Marlette Lake is used as an area to spawn fish. Well, I was curious. So I reached out to my friends at the Nevada Department of Wildlife, and sure enough, there was a spawning happening right at Lake Tahoe in Incline Village. I met up with Travis from Nevada Department of Wildlife to learn more about trout spawning and hopefully lend a hand. Travis was happy to accommodate. So I suited up, joined the crew, and we started the day.
What are we doing?
So this is an electro-fishing backpack. What it's doing is it's basically like a stun gun for fish. It doesn't injure them. It just temporarily demobilizes them, and it enables us to capture them without having to run like nets or actual fishing or anything that would be more intrusive for the fish.
So in layman's terms, you're gonna zap the water and it kind of stuns the fish, it doesn't hurt them, and then we scoop them up.
Exactly, that's an ideal situation.
How far up is this electricity going?
It's only running about 5 feet in front of us. So
shouldn't we be able to see them? Because I don't see any.
You would think, but it's amazing how well they can hide and how camouflaged they are when they're in the water.
All right.
And as we get more into kind of the shadowy areas, if there's any fish, that's where they're gonna be.
You're not gonna zap us?
I'm gonna try not to.
When rainbow trout spawn, they need the flowing water of a stream. The moving water keeps the trout's eggs clean from fungus. Travis and his team identified this stream as an ideal spawning location. This is where we started our day.
Cool, okay. We're good to go, so you ready?
This is crazy. How big of a fish am I looking for?
Anywhere from 12 to about 30 inches.
Wow. There's got to be an element to what you do that's very satisfying when it comes to helping the environment.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's number one. Just like this project in particular, seeing the increase in the population that we've seen over the last 6 years, and knowing that it's a direct impact of the work we've done, you know, to put more animals on the landscape and allow them to thrive is incredible. And a lot of people don't realize, you know, the work that goes into maintaining animals on the landscape, and how much effort is put into it. And so it's, you know, one, I personally like it, and two, it's fun to explain to people because a lot of people don't understand it.
Oh, you got, lift up, lift your net.
He got one, wow. That's a big one too. Nice job. How'd you see that?
I didn't.
He didn't.
He didn't see it.
Yeah, so that's exactly.
So how big would you say that one is?
I think like 18, 19 inch female.
Would you say the trout here are incredibly healthy? Because look at that.
Yeah, so these are some of the healthiest rainbow trout you're going to find anywhere, really.
And why is that?
Clean water, you know, an abundant source of forage. And
can you hold that up for the camera so we can take a good look at? Look at that. Look how beautiful that is. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Like very healthy?
Oh yeah, super clean. She's a female. She doesn't have a lot of eggs, but we're gonna hold her and we'll end up tagging her. We may not spawn her, but so I'm gonna give it to you, Bryce, and then just dump her in that upstream net pen. Thank you.
Wow, that was awesome.
We continued our march up the stream and secured a couple more trout.
Right there.
It's amazing how camouflaged these fish are. Couldn't see them right in front of me.
Got it.
How did you do that? Two in a row. Amazing.
Rainbow trout will travel several miles up a stream in search of the perfect place to spawn. But before that happens, Nevada Department of Wildlife has a series of holds and pens set up to secure the trout. It's here we get personal with the fish.
All right.
I'm still shocked at how I can't see them.
Yeah, it's incredible how well they can hide.
All right, so I'm just going to a dark corner, but I really don't know.
Yeah, that's really the only way to do it. Yep,
got him.
Up. Nice.
Wow, wow. Okay, now what do I do?
So we're gonna bring him up and over, don't let him out, and we're gonna put him in this net pen over here.
Jeez, he's huge. Tell me what you think the size and the weight of this one is.
So he's 24-ish and probably about 4 or 5 pounds. So if you just grab the bag with your free hand and just kind of dump him out.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Okay. There you go, buddy.
Perfect.
Wow, that is satisfying.
Yeah, right?
I want to be you when I grow up, man, if I could do this.
Yeah, that's a healthy fish there.
Okay, let's go to stage two.
First, we gathered up all the trout into one pen. Once they're all secure, they're prepped for extraction.
Stuff's gonna go everywhere.
In this one here?
Yep.
Hey, guys.
The males and females are separated, and each trout is naturally sedated for their safety. From there, the egg extraction begins.
So if you take her just like that, yep, and then do snout towards the front.
Or snout towards the front.
Yeah, there you go.
Sorry about that, sweetie. Sorry. That is 440.
Then I'm gonna run this over her. Nothing, and then you can set her in there.
So she is tagged twice, basically. Is that
she
right?
She will be, yep. Okay. So it's 990 because we go in grams.
990.
Yep.
All right.
And then I'll take her from you.
Okay.
I'm gonna give her a tag.
These fish are also tagged with a radio chip and contact tag. This is done to keep track of the fish as part of the overall study. The contact tag actually has Travis's phone number on it. So, when someone catches the fish, they'll contact Travis and he'll ask a series of questions.
So we go right in front of the dorsal fin.
Okay, and there's a child watching right now that says, does it hurt the fish?
So that's why we sedate them. I'm sure they're sore afterwards. And so then this is the visible Floy tag.
Wow.
And then we'll put her back in the water.
We continue to measure, weigh, and tag. This data is very important to the study of these fish.
540.
470.
And once this is completed, we can start the egg extraction.
Unbelievable. So that's 1,930.
Perfect. So now we got all these fish are tagged. We're gonna go ahead and spawn. So basically, you pull her out. I'm gonna clean off that anesthesia and then hold her like this. And you just very little pressure.
That's actually a beautiful color.
It's the same as the health of the fish. The health of the eggs that come out of these fish is impressive.
As a novice, I'd say it's very, very healthy.
Yeah.
Right?
You're right, your assessment is correct. And I mean, basically anyone who grew up fishing knows what a salmon egg looks like. And that's basically
right.
What we have here.
How many again?
So they can range. I mean, 500 would be a low number of eggs. 3,000 is high. These fish in Tahoe, when they're really ready to lay their eggs, typically are about 2,000 eggs per female.
When they release them in the wild, the eggs, do they release them in one spot, or is it?
Yeah, they all go in usually like Sand Harbor, which is just down the way, Cave Rock. So grab another one.
I mean, in the same spot in the stream.
Oh yeah, they do. Yep, they build what's called a red, so it's like a nest for fish in the rocks, and they'll lay their eggs in those rocks. So like. This girl's not ready to land. And so if you feel, you can feel how she's bulging, but she's kind of hard.
Like, yeah, right
that
there.
That means she's not ready to lay her eggs.
Okay.
She'd be really, really soft and loose if she was ready. So
you're gonna let her be?
Yep, we'll just let her go. We'll let her lay her eggs when she's ready. I get the impression we're gonna have a few of those.
So the eggs go in here, then what happens?
So once we handle these last couple females, I'll grab a male. And we will do the exact same process to fertilize the eggs.
So you're having about a 95% success rate with these eggs?
Yes, sir. Yeah, so, figure if we did 1,000 eggs, that's 950 fish.
And they get released back here and in other...
And in other places around Nevada. And, you know, they're, as you can see, they're all big, healthy fish. There's good genetics in these fish, so we want them in other places where people, you know, where they may be easier to catch than Lake Tahoe, so anglers can get out, catch some fish, and enjoy the outdoors. This one's not ready either. All right, so now we'll go with a male.
Now it's time to fertilize.
Exactly.
Once the eggs are ready, a male trout is brought in to begin the fertilization.
But it's the same process.
How long does it take for them to fertilize? What happens?
They're fertilized now. It's pretty instantaneous.
Wow.
Yep.
With the eggs fertilized, they're carefully cleaned and rinsed with the water from the stream. This removes any harmful materials to the eggs. Not only do these eggs go on to help stock lakes, streams, and ponds throughout Nevada, this study is also part of a bigger picture. This will hopefully bring back Nevada's cutthroat trout population, which is on the verge of extinction. The rainbow and cutthroat are very similar species, so the data collected here will be used to spawn cutthroat and build back its population in Nevada.
Those are basically dead eggs.
So roughly speaking, how many fish get released a year?
I'd say total across the state of Nevada, we're pushing 800,000 to a million.
Gosh.
Just knowing how many eggs that we produce.
Once all the eggs were collected, fertilized, and cleaned, it was time to get them counted and prepped for transport to the hatchery. Again, this was very time sensitive, so it was right to work, counting and packing.
It was 27 ounces.
27 ounces, yeah. So Taylor will fold them up. And so that's how they get transported. And then they'll go into this cooler down here.
The work is very time sensitive, and it's like a well-oiled machine. I was really glad I could be part of the team and help. Finally, with the eggs on the way to the hatchery, it was time to return the rainbow trout back to the lake.
Final part of their involvement in this process, right?
Yep, this is the last part of their long day. They taking them back home and let them head back out to the lake and hope we see them again next year.
How do you know they don't just go back up the stream?
Some do. The males specifically, that drive for them to spawn is so strong, a lot of them turn and head right back up the stream. The females, for the most part, are sick and tired of what we're doing, and they will let them go right here. And they just go ahead and swim out to the lake.
There they go. How satisfying is that to you?
It's awesome.
To see this part of it.
Yeah, to see, I mean, after what we just put them through and everything, and then to watch them swim off healthy is about as good as it can get.
So. It's about as good as it can get. I got to tell you something. You have taught me so much today. In part, nature doesn't happen by accident. Sometimes needs a little help if man's going to be involved.
Yep.
And I don't think people realize the work that you're doing here affects the entire state.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, I'm glad you took that from what we talked about because, yeah, there's guys, I mean, I'm not the only one. There's guys like me all over the country, Nevada specifically, a group, or guys and girls, good groups of them, out doing this exact stuff all over just so we can have, you know, the wildlife that a lot of people take for granted.
I got to say, on behalf of the state, on behalf of the fish, thank you, man, for
thank
everything
you.
That you're doing.
Thanks for the help, yeah.
This has been an absolutely great day for me.
Yeah.
Got to spend it out here with you and learn a lot. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you. The help is much appreciated. So
it's good stuff.